Hello, my name is Finnegan Bailey. This is my mini Maker Faire project, the 3D printed computer mouse. As you can see, this is a 3D printed shell on existing mouse parts, and it functions just like a regular mouse, but we'll get to that in a bit. This is one in a long line of many iterations of this. All of these were just tests, and as I learned more about what the guts needed to accommodate them, I made adjustments to the designs. By the way, all of these were designed in Tinkercad, printed on Mr. Miller's 3D printers. As you can see, the designs greatly change, with the end result looking very different than the beginning. And this actually did take me quite a long time. Now, a demonstration of how the actual mouse works. We have the mouse here. And as you can see, my mouse moves around just like it normally would. And click, open new tabs, play your favorite games like Animortal, as long as you don't click the icons. Yeah, that's my mini Maker Faire project, the 3D printed computer mouse. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Dara and I'm in 4A. For my Maker Faire project this year, I decided to make a basketball hoop rebounder. Every time I try to play basketball outside, my ball always bounces away after I shoot it, and I spend half the time looking for it. Therefore, I made a basketball hoop rebounder so that every time I shoot, the ball always comes back to me. See? It always comes back.
Hello, my name is Ashar, and this is the Doggy Bag. So, I thought about this because I was on a hike with my dog and my family, and I was thinking, instead of locking my dog like on a leash, I could make a backpack for him, and then he could like go around with someone carrying him on it. So basically what I did was I got this rope and this potato sack bag from Amazon. And then I cut the bag with scissors at the end. And then I put the ropes through the holes that I got with the scissors. And then I can kind of strap on the backpack. And I have a pillow under this so that my dog's paws don't get like, they don't go through. So yeah, thank you.
My name is Jacob Bellinger, and this is my 2022 mini Maker Faire project. I built a custom wooden vending machine that dispenses miniature Hershey's candy bars. There's four choices for the candy bars. First, the Hershey's milk chocolate bar. Second, the Mr. Good Bar Hershey's bar. Third, the Hershey's special dark chocolate bar. And fourth, the Hershey's crackle with crisp rice bar. Customer can choose which bar would they like and get the candy by pushing the button under the candy they like. So if I wanted a Hershey's special dark chocolate bar, I would push this button and I get my Hershey's special dark chocolate bar. I built the vending machine using three different types of wood. First, I used plywood for the outside. Second, I used pine wooden beams for the interior supports, and third, I used balsa wood for the interior mechanisms. So, in the back, we have the vending mechanism, which dispenses the candies out into the vending tray after the buttons are pushed, and you can see them right there. They go through the guides, which hold them in place, and they come through the boxes and push the candy into the vending tray. And if you run out of candy, you can take your candy and you can just drop it right back down into the box and it reloads for you. And so now I can just push that button and we have our candy. Thank you for watching.
Well, my name is Anton.
And I'm Sid. And this is our good bear candy.
So, as you can see here, we have a wooden structure that holds the water cup, which leads from the tube into the water.
Whether or not the plants are getting drier, you can adjust the valves to make more water come through. And
if you zoom in here, you can see that the water is slowly dripping. It's not pouring, but it is like it's just like a slow drip.
As you can see, this has proven to be an amazing mechanism. Sadly, our watermelon isn't thriving. It's dead. Our beans are really thriving, and our wheatgrass is doing amazing.
Thank you for listening to our science fair, and bye.
My name is Devin Brown, and this is my Maker Faire project. I call it the portions dispenser. Here we have some decorated PVC pipes, and atop them are 3 Gatorade bottles. These are the Gatorade caps, and inside the Gatorade bottles are the bottoms of Life water bottles. There are holes poked through everything, and shish kebab sticks going through, linking everything together. So the way it works is when you turn this, the Life water bottom will turn, and all the Fruit Loops will fall out. Then when you're done, you turn it back, and it'll block the Fruit Loops. This is normally wall-mountable, so we have 3 of these, which you can slide around these bits, and then nail them into the wall using these nails. And now I will demonstrate. It's gonna fall onto the table, but I take these, and then all I gotta do is turn them, and then the Fruit Loops come out, and when you're done, turn it back. This is my Maker Faire project.
Hello, I'm Dhillon, and today I'll be showing you my project that I did for Maker Faire. It's also called the Mark Rober experiment. And basically what he did is he was tired of porch pirates coming to his house, and so he decided to make a box with litter inside and fart spray. It's kind of a disaster. And basically he had cameras inside, and when the porch pirate opened the box, fart spray and glitter came out, and it was basically just a very funny prank. Well, I have basically kind of done the same thing, but very much modified it, and I'll show you here. I have, this is the motor, not the actual paper, but right there, that's the motor that helps spin this thing that puts all the glitter inside. Here, these wires, this is the battery, and the battery connects to this motor, and the motor also has another wire that's connected to this lever switch. And what the lever switch does is basically turn it on and off. So let's load this thing with glitter. We're just gonna do one type. Let's do, put some gold in here. This gold's really cool. And this is for me. Okay. And so I'm going to load some because I just fell. When I press this, it would spin, but if we hold this down, it doesn't. And I'll show you in 3, 2, 1. And that's basically how it works. It wasn't that good, but that's kind of how my experiment works. And thank you.
This is a Rubens tube. The tube shows how sound waves work by using flames to illustrate the frequency and resonance of sound waves. More waves mean a higher frequency, taller flames on that wave means higher resonance or a louder sound. So, how this tube physically works is that I have a propane tank here, a regulator to make sure that the pressure doesn't get too high, then a ball valve so I can somewhat control the flow of propane, then an adapter here that allows me to put this hose on. But then if we look down here, I have another one that's taped up because it was leaking. And if we look over on this side, right, I have a cap and it's also sealed by tape because it was also leaking, right? And then if you go over to the other side, there is a rubber diaphragm and some more tape to seal it off. And I have a speaker here, and what that does is it plays the sounds. So yeah, so right now I have a frequency generator pulled up on my phone. It's at 300 hertz, so it's a lower frequency, which means less waves. And then, if I go up to 500, you have a lot more fun. Instead of getting like a couple, you get five. But my favorite thing is to play music, because I get to play music really loud and annoy people.
Hi, I'm Alistair Chappell, and this is my Maker Faire project. On the bottom floor, we have this thing, which is called the condo, and it's hollow inside, so the cats can go inside and relax in it. To the left of it, we have a scratching post for them. Above it is a platform with a scratching board in the center. And this thing, which is a wall anchor, but the cats like to play with it, so we didn't attach it to anything. To the left of that is a basket for them to sit in, which we never do. And another scratching post. At the top we have the nest, which is inhabited by Winston currently, which is where they can come to relax. And then beneath it is a ball toy. This has been my Maker Faire project. Thank you.
So this is my mini Maker Faire project. For Maker Faire, I made a keyboard that, as you can see, works perfectly fine. I'm just not great at typing. So yeah, that's it.
Here's my cardboard soda vending machine that I made for my Maker Faire project. I built it out of cardboard, and I'm going to demonstrate how you dispense sodas and how you load it. So first you have your soda and you put it in through the back where there's a little hole. So you lift it in and then slide it on in. Close it up. Here's the lever mechanism that you pull down to dispense a soda, and it is attached with rubber bands, and it attached to the like little container that twists the soda inside. So there you have your soda.
Hello, I'm Zachary Cohen, and this is my Maker Faire project, a camera obscura. Camera obscura is very old technology. It was described by Leonardo da Vinci and was used by artists in the 17th century, and it's the predecessor to modern photographic cameras. It's basically a box with a small polar lens on one side, and when the light passes through that polar lens, an image is projected onto the surface opposite the hole, and the projected image is upside down. This is known as the pinhole effect, and for that reason, camera obscura can also be known as pinhole cameras. I made a camera obscura using a magnifying glass lens. And here is the screen opposite to the lens. The surrounding boxes serve the purposes of holding the lens and screen, getting the distance right for focus, and this is a box for blocking out the ambient light. When you point the lens end of the camera obscura towards the light source of an object, you should be able to see the image upside down on the screen. I experimented with different sizes and shapes of boxes, different materials for the screen, and different techniques. And I came up with this final version, which works pretty well. A camera obscura is a fun little project that you two could do easily at home. Thanks for watching my video.
I am John Goddard Connell.
And
And I'm Noah Cordes.
For our Maker Faire project, we made a Star Wars stop motion.
We had to take many pictures for the project and then edit it and add sound effects afterward.
We made a scene where Luke had a lightsaber battle with Darth Vader.
And a scene where Luke escaped the Death Star in an Imperial shuttle and shot the shot that blew up the second Death Star by the Millennium Falcon. We hope you enjoy our project.
I am Justin Dominus, and for my Maker Faire video, I made a step stool. And in this step stool, some of the functions are, there's an opening top step that covers a storage bin. And there's a retractable bottom step, which goes in and comes out. As you can see, I can't reach some of my sweaters and shirts. So before, I was using an old kitchen chair. And with that chair, I just stepped up and I could reach it. So I'm thinking, what if I make something that looks nice in my closet and I can even use instead of the chair? So I said, nothing better than a step stool. Thank you for watching.
This is my Maker Faire project. I'm gonna be explaining a few things. You can use whatever type of heavy cream, vanilla, or sugar, doesn't matter what brand it is. Also, you can use imitation vanilla extract if you can't buy vanilla extract. Just add a little bit more. Also, with the sugar intake, you can put however much sugar you really want. It doesn't matter, just how much you prefer. And pretty much it.
So, hi everyone. This is my like rough draft of my Coke can popcorn maker. And this is my final. I think I definitely improved from that. And this is the popcorn we're gonna be using. So you get it? It got kind of stuck to the bag, but you get it, and it's butter all over it. It's kind of disgusting. So you get it like this, then you pour it through the top. And then, with a knife that I have, and then with the knife, you gotta get it inside. You have to try to get it in the middle, like that, and we got matches right here, but I'm not gonna light a fire in here because it might be, because it's gonna be dangerous. So I'll take pictures of that. And once we do the lighting, I'll take some pictures of it popping into the bowl. Thank you, bye.
Hello everyone, this is my video for my Maker Faire. As you can see here, the Maker Faire isn't really well done because I ran into some problems while trying to make it, but like coding and stuff, it didn't work for me. But these are like the stuff, like the materials that I would have. That I have to use things like this and stuff. But overall, it seems like pretty good.
It seems like a pretty good Maker Faire or any like DIY project to make. Thank you.
Hello, this is my Maker Faire project, the Little Free Library. The reason why the post is not in the ground yet is so I can bring the library into school. The first thing I did was use the tools, materials, and instructions to build the Little Free Library. Next, I painted it using blue and white paint because those are the St. Albans colors. I chose this project because I wanted to encourage reading in my neighborhood. Overall, this was a very fun project to work on and I recommend trying it out. Now I will demonstrate how to use it. So you take the book, you unlatch the library, you open the door, put it in, close the door, and latch it again. And if anyone would like to take that book, they unlatch the door, open the door, take the book, close the door, and latch it again. This is the Little Free Library. Thank you for watching.
Alright, so this is the desk right here. This is the workshop. Me and my dad built the desk in. There's nothing really to test out. As you saw on my poster board, this is all made out of tent wood, scrap wood, and wood we found around the house. So, yeah, after the presentation, after the in-school thing, I'm just going to put this desk with my other desk and make like a corner desk in my room. And you can do like your homework on it, put a TV on it if you wanted to. And it's pretty sturdy, and it's also got wheels on the bottom that you can move. So, yeah. Overall, I think me and my dad did a great job building this.
Hello, my name is Will Gross, and I'd like to talk to you about my Maker Faire project. So for Maker Faire, I made a phone projector made out of shoebox, as you can see. So the way you would work is you have to go into a dark room, and you have to play a video or put a picture on, and place the phone down like this. So after you place the phone down, the mirror will project it to the magnifying glass, which will blow the picture up onto a wall. And if you have an issue with like the resolution, you have to move the shoebox closer or farther to the wall from the wall to get a better resolution. And you have to be in a dark room to use it because it cannot create enough light from the phone to the mirror to the mirror to the magnifying glass to create an image onto a wall where there's light. There has to be darkness. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put a video on my phone like this, as you can see. Put it full screen, and you can start playing the video like this. And then you have to make it full screen like this, like that, and then place it right there. So the way you would focus is to move closer or farther away to make a better resolution, like this.
Hello, my name is Henry Hall, and for my mini Maker Faire project, I made a zodiac sign buttercream funfetti cake. So, I started off by making the physical cake. And once I was finished with that, I took it out of the oven and let it cool completely. Then I melted white chocolate and put an entire layer of the white chocolate over the cake so that it's called a crumb coat, so that no crumbs get out when you're putting the frosting and fondant on it. And then, after I did that, I made, rolled out, and cut my fondant so that it would fit the cake. And then once I put that on, I used a brush to apply water to fill in all of the little cracks and holes. Then, after I did that, I let it sit so that the fondant could just dry down a bit. Then I put homemade buttercream frosting along the edges and did little accents around the cake. Then I used homemade buttercream frosting with pink food coloring in it to make this almost inward flame design, pointing towards four pearls representing the like wealth, something about the wealth of these specific zodiac signs. And the zodiac signs, Aquarius, before I ate it, Cancer, Scorpio, and Libra. And I drew those on with a very fine detail, like brush. And once I was finished with that, I cut it out, took a piece, the entire thing. It was really good. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Nate Hanbury, and I made these old school skateboards with my partner, Henry Pastillian. To make these old school skateboards, we used a polyvinyl transfer, which is putting the image onto a piece of wood. First, to make these polyvinyl transfers, we used an image and we added water to it and rubbed all the paper off until it stuck onto the wood. Then, the next part, we made these black lines, which were made out of spray paint. First, we outlined the board on where we wanted to put the spray paint. Then we spray painted it and wait until we had these really nice big black lines. There we go. And we also, to make this stuff, we bought the hardware and our trucks and bearings. We first put the bearings in the wheels and put the trucks on the board. And boom, your old school skateboard's ready to go. This is my partner's Henry Pastillian's board, and this is mine. Let's test these boards out.
Okay, hi guys, today I'm showing you my Raspberry Pi computer. So inside of the actual computer itself, you have the fan here, which is on, as you can see, and the motherboard inside. On the sides, you have the USB, this is the mouse and keyboard, and here is the power supply and other cords. And here's the micro SD, this is where the Raspberry Pi is, the operating system. And here's my keyboard and mouse that's connected to this. Here's the mouse and here's the keyboard. It works. And now I'm going to show you that it runs Minecraft Pi Edition. You can start game. And it will be, here's the Minecraft world. It's fully running. And also, it can fully run the internet. And you can even watch YouTube. You can surf on Google. And you can do everything. So here's YouTube. Give it a second. It's also connected to the Wi-Fi, so that's pretty cool. So as you can see, it runs YouTube. Also, you can do any questions. So you can look up on Google, see everything. So it's like a normal Google. And so you can do pretty much anything you want, but as long as it runs on the Raspberry Pi operating system. So this is my Raspberry Pi computer. Thank you.
I'm Ray Law.
And I'm William Law.
And this is our mini Maker Faire project.
It's called 2v2 Magnetic Soccer.
Each player is given two pieces. There's a 3D printed goal on either side, and there's a scoreboard on either side.
We made this field out of cardboard, canvas, and green felt.
Each player is controlled by a magnet placed to a handle, like so.
We'll now show you a quick demo.
3, 2, 1, let's go.
Ooh.
And it's just gone wide. Now he will start with the ball here. Ball's gone out again, and he starts with him.
Oh. That's a goal for me.
And now he will give himself 1 point. The first player to 5 points wins. And that is our Maker Faire project.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Joshua Weinstein.
I'm Jasper McKay.
And this is our Maker Faire project.
It's a fluidized sand tub.
So how it works is we blow the air up into the sand,
and it makes
the sand particles float in equilibrium. And so it makes it kind of like a fluid. And so
some things sink in it and some things float. Things like golf balls sink, but things like wiffle balls, they float.
They float.
We're using an air compressor to pressurize the air so that it gives enough force to make the sand particles float.
But once the pressure runs out, it'll stop working as well.
Go. You have to let the air pressure build up for a little bit.
Set by Charlie Marino. This is what I have done for this year's Mini Maker Faire. This is how the 3D chess set turned out when I designed it on Tinkercad. As you can see, it looks very well made, and one side is black and one side is white, but the knights and baroques did not always look so well made. As you can see, this is how they looked before I had to redesign them. This is baroque. It was actually unprintable. Some of the things wouldn't print out. Some of these things, they would not print out. So, yeah. This is the knight. It looks very blocky and very strange. It did not really fit the mood I was going for. But anyways, after I printed this out, it turned to look like this, which is what it looks like when it was printed out. Video or the picture's a bit blurry, but I'm sure you can see how it looked. It looked pretty good.
Hello, here is my Maker Faire project, a hand painted, hand drawn map of an island in a fantastical world. You can see the frames painted, and there are forests, wastelands, deserts, grasslands, and islands on the map. But there are also hidden messages and drawings and even islands that only show under UV light. We're going to take a closer look at that also.
Once we turn on the UV light, you can see that there are certain islands that appear, such as this one right here, the Island of the Gate. And then also there's a sea monster that appears, and Arachnid Island up there, and also some other things that appear. But also on the frame, now there seems to be some words right here. It says Hell Flame in the Blood Throne. I wonder what that means. And to Death Guard we go. It also has other words, such as "Why against pain?" Yeah, I wonder who wrote that. It's an interesting message. And blood and souls. Those are only some of the messages that are on this. Thank you.
Hello, Mr. Millenaform. This is my Mini Maker Faire project that I built in early March. It is my game PC, and I use it, and I love it, and I use it for everything. So I'm gonna tell you what parts I have in here. All these parts, I've handpicked them and done my own research to find out what would be the best for me and my budget. First up, we have the graphics card. It is the newest generation of RTX 3050 graphics cards. It is a powerful card. Then, I have the processor under the cooler. Processor It is the newest Intel 12th Gen i5, a 12600K. It is a really powerful motherboard. CPU. Then I have the motherboard. It's a Z690 motherboard with DDR5 RAM compatibility. And what makes it special is that it is compatible with my processor. Then we have the memory. The memory or RAM. The RAM is 32 gigabytes of DDR5. DDR5 is the newest, most powerful type of RAM. And then finally, we have the storage. I don't need to say much about this because I have 1 terabyte of storage. I think this is everything. Now let's see what this can do. It can run very demanding games like Hearts of Iron 4, which take up a lot of RAM, storage, and graphics. So let's see how it goes. It can run it really smoothly. As you can see, even though it's a very, very demanding game, and I don't think you can tell because of how good the PC is. And I really enjoyed making this PC, and it's probably the favorite thing I've ever built. And thank you, Mr. Miller and Aform, for watching my Maker Faire video.
Hello, Mr. Miller and everybody seeing this. This is me and Ozzy's mini Maker Faire project. It is a ramp that, it is a ramp that is 26 inches wide and 20 inches tall with a length of 30 inches. If you see all of our equipment back here, some materials we use the drill, we use, our wood saw. Now, to build it, our sides, and then we cut out our 2x4s. Once we had all those nailed together, we then put in some supports.
Did you nail them together?
Screwed them together. And then once we were finished with that, we had created our base piece. And then we lined it all up and we nailed it down. And one of our calculations a little bit off, and one of our pieces wasn't big enough, so we had to get a second piece, which is this one, which is nailed and secure. Well, yeah, that's my video, and here it is.
Hi, my name is Ethan McIntosh, and I'm here with my keyboard, and I'm partners with Sebastian Chen, and he also made one. So, this is my keyboard. These are the switches I used. Here's an example of one of the switches. I went for a more Japanese style with the cherry blossoms. Also, here is an example of the Holy Panda switches I used. These are the keycaps, and this is an example of a keycap puller. It's how I take the keycaps off. And you can also pull switches with this. It's very helpful. And yeah, this is Bluetooth, and you can connect it with the wire. Doesn't matter. It also has a little volume knob right here, which is really helpful. And yeah, that's my keyboard.
For my mini Maker Faire project, I built a cryptocurrency mining rig. My mining rig is currently mining Raven Coin. It is solving complex mathematical problems to verify transactions on the Ravencoin blockchain. A blockchain is a method of storing a list of entries that cannot easily be changed. The main components are as follows. The PCU, the power supply, the motherboard. On the motherboard is the random access memory, the central processing unit with its fan, and the SSD card, which is down there. This is the riser with the GPU mounted on it. And over here are the fans.
The fans are needed to cool down the GPU. I installed the two miner software and joined a Ravencoin mining pool. A mining pool is a group of miners that work together to complete a block on the blockchain. This is the dashboard, which shows the data of my mining rig. I'll be donating all the profits from my mining rig to the Steve Fast Foundation, which was founded by a close friend that recently died from cancer.
So this is my skim board. I made it for my Maker Faire project. It has three islands. It has a turtle and two dolphins near the bottom. I have a little grip stuff here so that I don't just slide off the board. And this shimmer stuff here is epoxy. And the backside, here's the backside, it's not that cool. And I have a little bit of a bow type thing. It kind of like tilts that way a little bit, so when I just throw it onto the ground, it doesn't just like dig straight in. It kind of tilts up, and that's kind of nice. And so yeah, I made this with my grandfather. And here we go. The water's kind of good. So 1, 2, 3.
Hello, it's me, Spencer, and this is my Maker Faire project.
My Maker Faire project was originally trying to make a walking AT-AT, but I was unable to do this, so it became a model AT-AT. This that you see right here is the upper section of the leg. You're going to see all of the pieces, there are four of them. You're going to see them all get put together at the end, but this is the upper section of the leg. This is the lower section of the leg. This is the foot, and hopefully the only thing that will touch the ground, assuming it doesn't fall. This right here connects with this part of the upper part of the leg. So, yeah. This is the body, or the main part of the AT-AT. Everything connects to it, and it when I was trying to make everything walk, this was where I would hold any like control panel or motors or anything like this. The fourth piece and final piece is the head. The head doesn't serve much of a functional purpose other than looking cool. It doesn't do much else, and you're going to see them all together, but as you can tell, this took a lot of tests. But eventually I came up with this. And as you can see right here, I started printing stuff in real life, but I didn't get to doing all of this. But the main project was building the design on Tinkercad.
Hi, this is Patrick Osterley. And for my Maker Faire, I made a gaming PC. So right here, we have the CPU cooling unit. So it cools the CPU, which is the brains of the computer, and it's like, and the CPU is directly below it right there. That middle bracket thing right there. And then right here is the RAM. This is like, and then down here is the GPU or the graphics card. It has this nice like RGB strip thing. And then right here, there's a fan here and a fan here. This helps cool the PC, make sure it doesn't overheat. And then to the side of the PC, we've got all, like, where you plug everything in. And that's the HDMI cord right there. And then up here, you can see this little antenna thing. This is so you can, the motherboard is a Wi-Fi motherboard. So that means that it has wireless Wi-Fi. And this is how you get your Wi-Fi. And also the motherboard, it's what holds everything in here. It's what everything's connected to. And then back here, we have all the wires, just back here. They're a little bit messy. And then they all connect to the PSU, which is this black box right here. And this like powers everything. And then it's like, this is just the back of the motherboard right here. And then we got like the top of the case, there's the on button. We have a USB port, a headphone jack, and yeah, that's what I did for my Maker Faire.
So this is our Maker Faire project. We have a PVC pipe base for a basketball arcade game. As you can see, if you come closer, we have a mini basketball hoop that I just bought off Amazon and installed right here with the crossbar. We can also see a little hole for our motion sensor, which Will talk about later in the video.
So I'm just gonna demonstrate how this works. So you come to the front and you just take a shot. I missed that one. It's okay though, everyone misses. See, that one I made. See how it just went right back to me? That's what the cloth's for, to catch the loose balls. Now I'll hand it over to Will and he'll show you about his part.
All right, so in the back here, I have just a little bit of a box right here. I'm gonna go to the other side so you can get the angle on it. But I'll tell you about the parts here. This is an MP3 to speaker. It's an MP3 to speaker. I have a 5-volt relay module over here. I have the motion sensor taped so it doesn't fall into the front. I have the power back here distributed to the breadboard. So when the motion sensor is triggered, it will send a signal. It'll send a signal to the relay module, which will then send a signal to the MP3 speaker, which will then play the noise requested that has been downloaded onto the speaker.
Okay. Thank you, Will. And that is our Mini Maker Faire project.
My name is Shiv Patel, and this is my Mini Maker Faire project. It is powered by the ESP32 camera board, which its intended function is a security camera. This board costs a meager $12.59 and has some very good specifications for the price. It has a 32-bit dual-core CPU. It also has 520 kilobytes of internal RAM and an external 8 megabytes of PS RAM. The minimal for running the highest resolution of video, UXVGA, is 4 megabytes of PS RAM. It supports low power mode and it has smart configuration, which means when you add in your specifications in Arduino, you can just boot up your camera and everything you wanted while coding will be there. It also supports picture Wi-Fi upload so that it automatically uploads over your web. It comes with one ESP32 cam board and one USB TTL adapter module. How you use it is you type in the IP address. Mine is not functional at the moment because of some coding issues. You type in the IP address, which an example would be 314 something something something, and then you would be able to use it.
Hey, it's Henry. So for my Maker Faire, I'm in a DIY book stand. And so it's kind of like that. And so it's like more portable and you can put it wherever you want. And so like I'll demonstrate here, it can hold like really any size of book. So this is like a regular size book. This is a bigger book, and then this is a really big book. So this project took a bit longer than I thought because when I was cutting the angles, that was really hard, but I think it turned out really well, and I'm really proud of it. Thank you for watching.
Hi, I'm Galt Roenbeck, and this is my Maker Faire project. It's a Simon game, or memory trainer, and I made this by soldering the components to the baseboard and then putting on the case and the buttons. And it works kind of like this. And if you get one wrong, it goes like that. and you can't play anymore until you press the start button again. Now, this wasn't my first project. I created a quantum DIY, but after I had everything soldered, it just didn't work, so I got this new one off of Amazon and soldered it again, and it worked. So yeah, this is my Maker Faire project, and bye.
Hi, my name is Ashar, and I'm going to be showing you how my swing works. First, we have two long poles and a beam connecting. Both long poles are built up of two shorter poles connected by bolts. The beam is connected to both poles by one bolt instead of two. Here, we have the beam that holds the swings. The swings are connected by bolts, and this long pole is connected by two shorter poles with this bracket attached, which attaches the long pole and the top pole. They are connected by bolts. Here on the other side, we have another two longer poles and one beam connected. Here we have our swings, which are made up of chains covered in plastic and plastic seats.
Hello everybody, here is my handmade 8-bit CAD console. As you can see, you see my PCB board right here, and you can see all the other components that help me create this project. This is my buzzer, my LED, all of my buttons right here, and this is my reset button. There are thousands of games on this console that I have built, but I will be talking to you today about some of the challenges that I encountered. When I finished creating and building this console, when I turned it on, the screen wouldn't actually turn on. So it would look something like this. However, the buzzer and the LED would still work. So I knew that it was an internal screen problem. I immediately sent an email to support at 8bitcade.com, and the owner responded, Jack Daly, and he got on a Zoom call with me and he taught me many things about soldering. The problem turned out to be that there were too many cold solder joints, and I had no idea what a cold solder joint is. So he explained to me that when I solder, I need to make sure that the solder is in the shape of a volcano instead of in the shape of a ball. The reason behind this is a couple of reasons. You want to make sure that the electricity is flowing fluidly through the entire Game Boy. Now, another thing that I learned was you don't just apply solder to keep things in place, but in fact, you apply solder so that the electricity can flow fluidly through the whole entire piece of machinery. Now, this is very tiny machinery, so once I had finished fixing the screen, I encountered another problem. The right button wouldn't work, and I did many tests to see what the problem was with the owner. And what turned out to be the problem was I had fried the whole entire thing. So I took ear pods, and what I did with the ear pods was I cut them so that I got a wire, and I short-circuited basically the whole entire Game Boy. So I connected the battery to the starter and the button so that I could get the whole entire right button to work. After this, the whole entire project worked, as you can see.
Hello, and this is my Maker Faire project. It is a rocket, and we will launch it. So yeah, I'll launch from this controller here. So. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And so that is my Maker Faire project, and yeah. So yeah, thanks for seeing this video. And now I have to find my rocket. If you don't find me at school tomorrow, then I'm probably lost in that Maryland wilderness.
Most people agree that the game of chess was originally played in India around 600 AD and then traveled around the world and evolved into the game we play today. Did you know that the word checkmate comes from the Persian word shamat, which means the king is dead? Hi, my name is Gavin Tang, and for my Maker Faire project, I made a portable chessboard. In Mr. Miller's class, we made a pawn piece with three printers, and I wanted to expand on that and make an entire chess set that you could take anywhere with you. So I made this. This is a portable chess set, and inside are the pieces that I designed through Tinkercad and that I 3D printed. And this is, the board is an old tray that I found, and to use it, I had to cut it in half, put hinges on it, and then add magnets in the inside so that it would hold. And the tiles, the black tiles, are the same stain that I used for the board. For the board, I had to sand it and then stain it. And one of the problems I ran into was that I cut it at a slant, and so I had to trim it. But then I realized the tiles won't fit, and so I had to add another piece of wood to let the tiles fit, and so that's straight. And another problem I ran into was that when I opened it, there was a gap. So I had to add a second piece of wood, but then I realized that it wouldn't open fully now. So I had to sand it at an angle so that it could open. This is my Maker Faire project, and thank you for watching.
Hi, my name is Duran Taswell, and this is my mini Maker Faire project. I made a PVC pipe happen. To make this, I used 3 5-foot PVC pipes. I also used fittings. So I have 5 angle fittings, 3 T's, and 4 elbows. I spray painted the hangers, which I put the hats on red, and the rest blue, with the middle also. Here's the demonstration of the pinning. Thank you for listening to my Maker Faire project.
Hi, my name is Alexander Tiffin. For my mini Maker Faire project, I made custom shoes. They are based on black Air Force Ones with the blue flame design. I got my idea while I was shopping for a new pair of shoes. I didn't like any of the shoes that I found on StockX, Goat, or eBay. So I just decided to make my own. I got these shoes for $150 base, but I bought a paint set that came with brushes, paint, and a box, I guess. And that cost about $30. So the total price of this would probably be $180. I made these by basically first painting the main areas of the shoe, the toe, and the swoosh in blue. Light blue, not just blue. And then, where I wanted to paint flames, I got some blue paint, painted an outline, filled that in, and then just kept on getting lighter and smaller until I got to white. What I took away from this project was that painting's hard. It's really hard. I had to continuously cover up mistakes using black paint mixed with white because the black, like jet black, doesn't mix well with these shoes. And yeah, they're cool.